As of March 9th of 2025, there are currently 47 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 2 more than were erupting last week. One of the 8 actively erupting volcanoes within Indonesia is the Dukono volcano, which has been continuously erupting for 92 years straight and counting. Dukono produces fairly frequent volcanic explosions, which eject ash and bombs of lava, often throwing them beyond its currently active crater rim. As a result, a 4-kilometer exclusion zone from the center of Dukono's active crater is currently in place. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Costa Rica, there was a new eruption of the Turrialba volcano and a greatly increased rate of eruptions at the Poas volcano. Meanwhile, in Japan, the alert level was raised at the Yakedake volcano due to the detection of summit inflation and a rise in the rate of daily earthquakes. And in Hawaii, the Kilauea volcano put on another spectacular show as it produced its tallest lava fountains in 39 years. These lava fountains peaked at around 4:09 p.m. local time on March 4th, reaching sustained heights of 600 feet for a time, with intermittent spurts of lava reaching even higher, up to 750 feet in height. This meant that lava fountains actually exceeded the height of the caldera rim edge, allowing the lava fountains to be directly seen from all of the caldera's viewpoints, creating a fantastic spectacle. While this is quite impressive, it does not surpass the 1,000-foot-high threshold marking tall prior Kilauea lava fountains, being dwarfed by lava fountains produced in 1983, 1969, and 1959. However, just like each of these prior eruptions, the current ongoing eruption, which has been intermittent since December 23rd of 2024, has consisted of repeated episodes of lava fountaining interspersed by periods of no lava effusion occurring. Those prior eruptions involved as many as 44 lava fountaining episodes, and with the 12th episode beginning at 7:30 a.m. local time on March 4th and occurring solely in the southwest corner of Kilauea's summit caldera, the current eruption has now tied the number of lava fountaining episodes the 1969 to 1974 Mauna Ulu eruption experienced. Episode 12 of the ongoing eruption was intermittent and weak for its first 7 hours, occasionally sending weak lava flows beyond both of the erupting vents. Increased sustained activity began at 2 p.m., with lava fountains progressively increasing in height over the next 2 hours. After the majority of Kilauea's down draft block was covered by a layer of fresh lava that made it 2.5 meters or 8.2 feet shallower than it was beforehand, eruptive activity declined until it ceased the following morning. This represented Kilauea's longest eruptive episode of 2025, and now we are expecting episode 13, perhaps even with similar height dual lava fountains, to begin between March 11th and March 13th. Meanwhile, in Japan, on March 4th, the alert level of the Yakedake volcano was increased from green to yellow in response to both the detection of summit ground deformation and an elevated rate of earthquakes. Yakedake is a mainly andesite stratovolcano located 35 kilometers west of Matsumoto in central Japan. While some people live on the outskirts of this volcano, it is noteworthy for having a history of producing unexpected and sometimes even almost impossible to predict phreatic eruptions such as what occurred in 1995. Unlike many other volcanoes in Japan, earthquake swarms at Yakedake in the last 75 years have preceded volcanic eruptions a double-digit percentage of the time, hence why there is currently a warning to people within 1 kilometer of its summit, where the inflation and earthquakes are occurring. This summit area is littered with a dozen distinct eruptive vents, primarily explosion craters that have been generated by eruptions during the last 2,500 years. While a phreatic eruption has not occurred at its summit since 1962, people in my opinion should avoid at least a 1 kilometer radius around its summit. And in Costa Rica, this week saw a brief and weak phreatic eruption occur at the Turrialba volcano on March 3rd, its first since 2022. However, what was more notable was the fact that increased eruptive activity is occurring at the Poas volcano, with some days in its acidic crater lake consisting of more than 100 small phreatic explosions. This unusually high level of activity occurred alongside what appears to be minor amounts of ground uplift, suggesting the possible intrusion of a new batch of magma, and at the same time the phreatic activity has caused its acidic lake level to drop. A high rate of small eruptions is likely to continue during the near-term future at Poas. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on March 8th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.